two, one. Go on.
Ah,
oh. Come on. Go on. Go on. This is Think Outside the Box. Hello and welcome to Think Outside the Box. Today I am joined by two more guests, Andre and Doug.
Pleasure to be here, pleasure to be here.
And Doug, do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, so my name's Douglas. I'm a third year biology student here at the University of York. Absolute first time on YSTV, so just going to see how it goes.
Okay.
Brilliant.
Hi Andre. Guys, I'm Andre, economics and politics student, third year. I like watching TV shows and this one looked fun, so now we're here.
Yeah, that's good. And are you both confident?
Yeah, very confident. Obviously, an avid watcher of Think Outside the Box, so I know how things go, and I've been trying to think of the weird and wacky, so...
No, I'm not confident. I'm dreadful at this kind of stuff, so I'm the underdog, but we'll see what happens.
They do say audiences like an underdog, so maybe you'll do well. So let's look at an example question just to see how it goes. So, this would be the example question, south, west, north, and the missing one would obviously be...
Kanye West's children.
The missing one would be east, as in just the directions. I oversimplified it just for the example.
East, yeah. Okay.
Oh, no.
North, west, yeah. That makes sense, okay.
Yeah.
That
makes sense.
And so that is example. So there'll be one word outside the box which is missing. They've just got to find that word. And there'll be a theme uniting it. So, yeah, that's pretty much how the questions roll. And in round one, the way it works is there are the regular questions worth 1 point, and there are the golden questions worth 3 points. So let's get right into it. Ooh. Backstroke, pressure. Andre.
Is it butterfly and swimming, like, strokes?
Yes, butterfly is correct. Well done.
Oh, man.
And, yeah, the theme was the swimming strokes, which now means because you got that right, you get a point, and you get a shot at the golden question.
Okay.
So if we go to the golden question... Let's see what's going on. So there's 6 words in this one, and let's just add the first word. Microwave.
I'm going to say kitchen, appliances, and go with oven. Is that how it goes, like that, or no?
I mean, all you technically need to give me is the missing word.
Just the missing word, okay.
But you can give a theme if you want.
No, we'll hit you with oven.
Sadly, that is incorrect, okay. But it's a good guess from just this first word. And so that means we get to go back to the regular questions.
Okay.
Time to redeem myself.
Yeah.
Doug might get a shot at that. Next question. Short Trenta Demi Tulum Grande. Doug.
Espresso.
You're on the right lines, but it's incorrect.
Demi Short Trenta.
Which means, Andre, can you steal this?
Short Trenta Demi Tool Grande. Latte, because it sounds Italian. And different sizes of coffee. No, it's not that, but gone.
You're close. So latte's incorrect, but it is the sizes.
Yeah.
These are the sizes you get at, like, Starbucks and that. And does anyone think they have it, or should I just
go with it? The only... Medium...
That makes sense.
I'm sorry.
Is that close or not?
I think it's...
It begins with a V.
Venti.
Correct. Well done, Doug. Yes. Oh, as soon as we got that V in there.
Yeah, it's just that you gave it away with the V, I think.
Yeah.
Damn. Guys.
All the times I've been to Starbucks just came flooding back.
Yeah.
The frustration with the sizes.
Yeah.
That's not fair, I've never been to Starbucks, actually, so...
Why don't they just name them small, medium, large?
I'd much rather they did, but...
Yeah.
You can't change the world, can we?
Like, a venti means nothing to me. So let's go to the golden question. Doug, can you get it with this next word? Radio.
So I'm thinking probably household appliances. Do I just have to come up with any word that I think might also be on there?
this is quite a limited theme, so it's not going to be a really open topic.
Ooh, okay.
But
I think I know this one actually.
You can give a word which you think is. It's hard to get at this stage.
So
I know what this is. I know what he's doing.
I think.
Like, yeah.
I'm just going to go for X-ray.
Correct.
Brother,
well done.
Day, yeah.
Yes, it is X-ray. This is the electromagnetic spectrum. And so do you have any others which are just for fun? Do you think you can work out any of the others?
Ultraviolet.
Ultraviolet, yes.
Visible light.
Yes. There's like a bit like radiation.
Gamma?
Yeah, gamma rays.
Is beta ray? No, it's not beta ray, isn't it? No.
And then the other one would be infrared.
Oh, infrared, yeah, of course. My favourite.
Those are the ones I had on here. And yeah, that's pretty cool.
Well,
so if we go back to the regular questions, we're going to be going into round two. And in round two, it's double points. So these are worth 2 points. The gold ones are worth 6. So yeah. Ooh. And going into round two, Doug is on 4 points. And Andre is on 1 point.
What?
Yeah. So it's still all to play for, though, because with double points, anything can happen. So let's go on to the next question. Ooh, fried eggs, cola bottles, bears, and hearts. Andre.
Okay, this is Haribo's, isn't it?
What's missing?
Fried eggs, bears, cola bottles, hot throbs, gummy bears.
We've got bears there.
Fuck.
So, unfortunately, Doug.
Rings.
Correct. Yes, it is rings. Well done, Doug. That was a good steal.
Were you going to get that if I didn't say that? Or?
I think I got that it was the Haribo trend.
Yeah.
But my mind was like, I couldn't think of what wasn't there. So I just had to do a bit of thinking.
Yeah. Yeah, I was hoping it'd be quite difficult to come up with the ring. Yeah. But let's go to the gold question. Doug, can you get another gold question? And so if we go 5 words in this one, and the next word, well, the first word, albatross.
So the albatross is a bird. I know that it can fly a really long way. But I'm sure they've probably also called some aeroplanes albatross. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll just go out on a limb and just say Spitfire, just because that's my favourite aeroplane.
Sadly, that's incorrect. I do like your thought process.
Yeah, I was just thinking outside the box.
Yeah. That was good, but sadly, it is incorrect. Very hard to get from albatross. So, let's go to the regular questions. And looking at the regular questions, the next one is, astronomy, transfiguration, charms, defense against the dark arts, herbology, and history of magic. Doug.
Oh, so it's got to be Harry Potter related. They're all subjects that they study at Hogwarts. My Harry Potter knowledge, a little bit lacking. Potions?
Correct. Yes, it is potions. Well done. And these are the Harry Potter classes. Well done there. Harry Potter knowledge may be lacking, but you did get it right. And so you get another shot at the gold question.
Okay. Let's see.
So if we go back to gold question. And the next word, condor.
All right. So definitely we're on the theme of birds. I just have to name another bird. Maybe red kite.
That is sadly incorrect. I do like that you're picking up on a bird theme. That is cool. But sadly incorrect. So we're going to have to go back to the regular questions. Maybe Andre can get one and steal the gold questions. Wow. Let's see. Oh, this is the next question. We are on it now.
Okay.
Remember, buzz the second you think you've got the answer. Meg, oh yeah. Andre.
Okay. Is that Family Guy characters? And no, yes.
What is missing? That's all I need, the missing word.
Is it... Is it Stewie?
Yes, it is Stewie. Okay. Well done. Okay. Well done. Okay. So that you banked 2 points for that, and you get to go for the gold question now. Maybe you can take it, because there will be 3 words. That eagle.
Okay, so I need to say just one word, or one word and the category as well.
Just the word is necessary, but you can give the category if you want.
Let's hit you with raven.
Incorrect, sadly. I see you're very much on the bird theme as well. And yeah, that is unfortunately not correct. So we're going to have to go back to the regular questions and see if another word may help. But next question. Ooh, Guernsey, Jeff, Holden, Isak, and Brecken.
Okay, Andre. Is that separate, like British Isles? Is it Jersey?
Jersey is correct. These are the Channel Islands.
Okay.
Well done. Yeah. Well done.
But well done on getting Jersey. That's good.
Thank you.
And it means that you do get another shot at the gold question. So okay. If we move to the gold question and add the next word, ace.
Albatross, ace, eagle, I don't even know if it is it birds? Is it birds? Ooh. Bro, I swear,
it may or may not be birds.
Condor, eagle. I feel like this could be a song, I'm not going to lie. Maybe I'm talking, he doesn't seem convinced. Okay, yeah.
I mean, there are definitely 3 birds here.
Ace, albatross, eagle, condor.
Maybe it's not birds. Maybe it's something just related to bird names. Anything coming to mind at all?
No, not the albatross thing I've only heard from a song, but then Doug explained this is birds, so I'm thinking, I don't know. I've never heard of a bird ace, to be honest with you. So.
Nor have I.
Yeah. Do you want to just give a random answer?
Yes, we'll hit you with pterodactyl.
Pterodactyl is incorrect, sadly. Really? But I think you already knew that.
Yeah.
let's go on to the regular questions. And this is the next question. Are these names ringing a bell? Louis, Charlotte, Lilibet, and Archie. Doug.
The only thing I could think of is maybe it's the famous five. And to be honest, I don't even know the famous five that well. So I don't even know if the name that I'm going to say is right. But I was going to say George, but...
Mate, he looked at it like, no way.
that is very surprising because George is the right answer. But it's not the famous five.
Is it not? It's not the famous five.
This is the king's grandchildren.
Oh! King's grandchildren.
King's grandchildren.
But George works. I only need the answer, so well done. I don't think that's happened before.
Would you think that's an iconic moment for the YSTV highlights reel?
Go down in history.
Yes, that is a moment for history.
Okay.
And let's go to the gold question and see if we can get some similar luck. So this will be the last word being added in. So it's important.
No.
Yes.
So these are all golf. This is golf related. Because you can... I'm guessing you can get a pie, an eagle, an albatross, a condor, an ace. But the special word that you're thinking, I'm not sure. Could it be hole in one?
So I will say the ace is also referred to as a hole in one.
Oh.
So I won't take that as your guess because obviously. But
is it birdie?
Yes, it is birdie. Well done. And that means you have taken this gold question as well, which is worth 6 points. So, well done. And that does end the second round.
Okay.
And going into round 3, where the questions are worth 3 points each, Andre is on 5 points, and Doug is on 16. that is a really nice lead you've got there, Doug.
I'm enjoying myself. Obviously, done a lot of revision for this, so yeah. I'm not surprised about the score.
But can you keep that lead in a round where there's 3 points? Andre, do you think you can mount a bit of a comeback?
So mathematically, I can make a comeback. statistically, it's unlikely.
So this round is quick fire, and there is no gold questions. We're just going through some regular questions. So let's go on to first question of this round. Ooh, this is an interesting one. Santa Claus, the Sandman, the Boogeyman. Yes, Andrew.
Is it like titles of like movie characters, and is it the Grinch?
Incorrect.
Okay.
Doug, can you take this?
Well, I'm just thinking of like made up people.
It's a specific group.
Oh.
Yeah, well they are made up people, but there is a
I was just gonna say Peter Pan.
Incorrect.
Incorrect.
Right. Well, to give you a clue, they are from a specific movie called Rise of the Guardians. And this person is linked to the cold.
Is it Jack Frost?
It is Jack Frost. Well done. Yes, 3 points. Maybe that comeback is coming off.
Come on. Let's do it.
And let's go to the next question. Ooh, this is an interesting one. Betrayal, Ghost of Sparta, A Call from the Wilds, Ascension, and Chains of Olympus.
Is it 300? And is it like war movies?
That is incorrect, sadly. But I like your, I guess, historical.
My intuition, thanks. We're doing intuition points now, or is it just like, yeah.
You don't get points.
It's a good observation. Oh, okay, I mean, with words like Sparta and Olympus, you can see why.
I don't think I could come up with a better answer, though.
Any guesses?
Oh.
Right, opening out to both of you, I'm gonna give a clue. It's from a video game series.
Is it Assassin's Creed?
Incorrect. Right, it features around a character called Kratos. The game series is called God of War.
Nah, I was never gonna get that. What about you? The
answer for people at home is Ragnarok. There was a game recently. Hoping to jog your memory, but obviously it's a specific knowledge. So let's move on to the next question. Maybe we can get some points back in there. Ooh, Andre.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to say this is Six Nations rugby teams, and is it Wales? Oh. No, fuck, France. No, it's France.
It's France.
That is so sad.
How was that, bro? I literally...
Doug, well done. It's 3 points.
Actually, I can't celebrate that one. I can't celebrate that one.
No, bro.
That should have been yours, Andre.
How did that happen?
Let's go on to the next question. Maybe, Andre, you can redeem yourself.
Yes.
Ooh. War, conquest, and famine. So it would be 4 things. War, conquest, famine, and something else. Doug.
I'll just say what I want to see. Maybe peace. Everything else seems like quite depressing. So a little bit of peace would probably go a long way there.
Peace would go a long way. But I'm sad to say there's no peace here.
Okay. I'll hit you with a depressing one. Hunger.
That would be famine.
Wow, we already got it.
Sad to say, so a clue is these are horsemen.
Of the apocalypse.
Of the apocalypse, yes. But maybe that doesn't help. I don't know.
Poor horseman.
This last one is a negative thing. A very negative thing. And it begins with the letter D.
Death.
Yes, Andre, death.
Okay.
You got in quick as soon as I got the letter D in
there.
Yeah, unfortunately, there's no peace in the horsemen of the apocalypse.
it was a bit far-fetched, that one, but...
Yeah. It's worth a shot.
Yeah. I was just thinking.
And unfortunately, that is all we have time for in this third round. And at the end of the show, remember, loser has to wear a box on their head.
Oh, no.
And the winner gets the think outside the box. Andre, you are on 11 points.
Go on.
Doug, you are on...
I'll come out now.
19!
Yes! There we go.
Well done. So, Andre, if you look down there behind you, there will be a wooden box which you have to wear on your head. Yes. You have been boxed. And, Doug, for the rest of the episode, you get the gold Think Outside the Box
thank
box.
Thank you so much. It was it's an honour to participate, and I feel like I'm being rewarded.
Yes, and that sadly marks the end of another fun episode of Think Outside the Box. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you later. Bye.